When you want to work with loudspeakers in rooms, there can be several scenarios. Sometimes it is just the speech transmission index that you want to fulfill some kind of requirement. But sometimes if you have a performance space or a space like this church with a natural source, a priest speaking, you also want to make sure that the localization is achieved. And this can be a challenge if you have loudspeakers much closer to your receiver position. In Odeon, you can achieve a good localization by using an automatic HAAS function, which I will show you now. In the church, I have placed loudspeakers along all of the columns, and the priest is located close to the altar. Then I have applied one receiver point, and I have calculated a job where all of the loudspeaker had the same sound pressure level and the same delay. So let's try to listen to how this will sound. We go to the streaming convolution and find some kind of speech.
The Athenian Bar was joined by the Athenian
As you can hear, it can be difficult to hear the localization of the priest. Where is the priest situated? And also this room is a big challenge because it has a extremely long reverberation time. I have the same room here. We will try to look at the sources. So if we take a look at a single loudspeaker, we can see that I have chosen the subdirectory called Yamaha and this type of loudspeaker. The CF2 files you can get from a homepage called the clfgroup.org, which is a common loudspeaker format that is open. And here you can download some different kinds of loudspeakers. If you go to download manufactured data, you can see what is available. In the right side, all the ones saying download has some loudspeaker directivities available directly on this homepage. Otherwise, you must go to the manufacturer and ask them for the data, or maybe you can find it on their own homepage. But the Yamaha is available, the Yamaha loudspeakers from the CLF file here down in the bottom of the list. And it is very easy to take these files and save them. You say save. Then you go to the directory where Odeon is situated, and it's normally at the C drive. And at me it is under Odeon 10 combined. And you go to the DIR files, and in this I have made some different folders for the different loudspeaker types. There is this one, for example, and you save it. Okay, so that is the common loudspeaker format. But what you can do from within this point source editor, you can also view the, if you have defined a grid, you can view the direct sound. How is the sound emitted from one source at a time? So you can use the numbers at your keyboard and go through the levels. See down here what are the levels in different positions, or you can just look at the scale out here. So this information you can use, you can say maybe outside of a 6 dB decrease of sound pressure level, you might want to place the next loudspeaker. I have defined these source with precision and azimuth and elevation. All have this the total overall gain of minus 40 dB and no delay. We want to make a better localization. What we do is we select the priest, which is a person who's talking with a raised voice. We select this, the priest, because we want this to be the point of localization. Then we go to the Haas window, and here we can define, compared to all of these loudspeakers, we define a receiver point, and it has to be connected to the nearest loudspeaker. So worst case is you are very close to one loudspeaker, and in this situation the loudspeaker closest to you might be the point of localization. We want to avoid this. So therefore this near zone radius says how close to the loudspeaker will we not accept a different kind of localization than the priest direction. This is a trade-off. If we put this very, very close to the speaker, the sound pressure level from the loudspeaker will be so small that it might not have any effect at all. So you can experiment with different distance to the nearest loudspeaker. Height above floor, that is just where is the person sitting above the floor. And these levels and delays is just some default levels that is normally used in Haas. So then you can add all of the receivers that will be defined to achieve the calculation. I will tag this to show you how the receivers will be placed on the line of the loudspeaker directivity. Calculate Haas delays, yes, and deleting the results. So now we can see the gain and the delay has changed for all of the loudspeaker. Only the priest keeps the same. So in this point we can see if has this affected the auralization now. I'll do a calculation of this. Meanwhile, I like to show you this graph relatively which level and delay is acceptable if you want to achieve a localization in the direction of the priest or the performer you want to keep within the Haas window. Now the calculation is done and we can listen to the how it will sound. If we want to compare it, we will try again to listen to the auralization from the beginning. The Athenian was joined by the Athenian. So we can also try to look at the STI in the two different cases. This is without the localization of the Haas effect. And here we have it with the Haas effect. It is exactly the same STI, but as you might be able to hear, there's a big difference in the localization. Still, this church is a very reverberant one.